books.
How video analytics is working nowadays?
Video analytics, unfortunately, video analytics is hampered by one big player called YouTube. So whatever videos you put up is analyzed using YouTube, but YouTube also has an API. So you can do that. The trouble with video analytics is simple. You have a 2-hour lecture. Ma'am, I'll come to you. You have a 2-hour lecture. People play it once, right? After 10 minutes they leave. And people play for 5 minutes. So video analytics is not so refined as website analytics. Text analytics is much more. I can know precisely where in the web page that person clicked, hovered, lingered. I can even make a heat map of that. I can say 10 minute tak ruka, 5 minute tak ruka, kidhar link par gaya, kya padha, kis pe se hi ek bounced. Yes, your question.
So analytics seems to be the buzzword today. Everybody is into analytics in some form or the other. And that's highly data driven. So it's still early days for data and all industries, but do you think data privacy laws, etc., will prove to be an impediment?
Not in this country.
In this country, yes, but
no,
globally?
Not in this country. I'll give you a very specific example. In the US, you have something known as usury act. You cannot make more than 25% as an interest rate. You also have something known as fair credit lending act, which means I cannot deny credit based on criteria like variables or your race. Even if my model tells me that you are risky, so I have to come up with other proxy things. I can't deny loans to genders or ethnicities, even though the analytics say that. Even in finance, as of today, we don't have fair credit lending. You can be a businessman and try and get a loan versus being a salaried person and try and get a loan. Do you ever get the reason your loan is refused? No, you don't. This is a very highly regulated industry. Now you're talking about not so regulated industry where internet, e-commerce, you know, whatever data I get as a modeler, as a data miner, is data that is out there. You have volunteered it. That's one. Second, I can't regulate it because the intermediaries like people like Google, Facebook, they will not accept a request from the Indian government saying ki this is against our Siddhant. They will accept a request by the Chinese government. They do that. So data privacy comes from where? From you. You have to be organized, or the government. Both those parties are fortunately, unfortunately, not organized enough in this country.
So, suppose as a card member, I have shared something in good faith with my bank or financial.
There's no such thing as good faith in law. We're talking law here. I am a data miner. Why do Google try to collect so much data for free? Because the more data you give me, the better my model becomes in predicting what you are going to do next. I'll give you a specific example. I'll come to you, sir. I'll come to you. If you tell me what dress you've been wearing for the past 30 days, right? And what you've been eating for breakfast and the temperature of the day, I can predict what you're going to wear for the next 4 days. That's scary. That is scary coming from me. Right? But it's also because human being behavior is very cyclical. It's very predictive. When the weather is certain way or your mood is a certain way, you like to listen to X type of songs, you like to go to a certain mall, you like to spend money. The data you volunteer on Twitter, on Facebook, on Google, everywhere, is not in good faith.
I agree, that's all public data.
You have to sue somebody. Somebody has to file a PI. In this country, PI does work. Supreme Court works. So file a PIL and get me, and that is the only way you can restrict people like me.
It your experience, how do your client organizations protect the output of their data analytics?
Multiple ways, including encryption. The output of the data, we want the, how to collect the data or output of the data?
The output of the data, once you've analyzed it and given them that, how do they protect it?
So first thing, when I specify the legal agreements, there are non-disclosure agreements, there are penalties, that's just the hygiene factor. Second is separating the hardware environment. I can't, you know, take out the data if possible. I try to do that as much as possible because I have multiple clients. Third thing is they try and anonymize it. So they will not tell me ki kiska data tha, kaun se client ka data. Right? They will not try and not tell me which the name of the customer. Like if you have retail data, they will not tell me name of customer or phone number. I don't need it. Fourth way is encryption. So I had a client who used to use PGP encryption even for downloading and uploading. So that's what you do. You encrypt and you give data only on a need to know basis. Last guy, just the last guy asked a question.
Sir, there are a number of entrepreneurs who start.
Wait for a mic, please. What's your name?
My name is Sony Goy. And when anyone starts a business or any idea, they do a lot of data mining, market research and all that. Once the business is on, you know data analysis is important, but you must have come across the experience, even knowing this fact that doing the data analysis is important, people are not able to do it. So can you tell what are the reasons that people are not are ignoring this such an important task?
Because you know, economics is the theory of study of incentives. People are not incentivized to think in terms of data. If I put your bonus on the quality of reports you give me, you will make better reports. No, I will put my bonus on sales kitna aa raha hai, numbers kitne ho rahe hain. Uske baad, you know, data analysis generally treated as the last thing, as a good to have thing. You are not incentivized for analytics.
That's post-mortem.
This is a post-mortem.
It's a post-mortem. So one thing which you are talking about is the predictability based on the behavioral pattern.
Yes.
What about the unpredictability? Like a human being is aware of human emotions, IQ, EQ, SQ. Right. How to capture them and how to use the data?
Human beings are still predicted. Even when we shift, we just shift to another plane. So I might shift from a corporate career to an entrepreneur career, but then I become predictable as an entrepreneur. You see, I'm predictable. My unpredictability happens when I shift from one kind of behavior to another. Once I do that, after a certain period of stabilization, I become more predictable.
And those who have already married, they are very much
right. He has to come back
predictable.
Right?
So I have two questions here. This is Vijay. Go ahead.
Right.
Which sectors in India, I mean, if I was to say financial sector, auto or insurance, which sectors are more amenable to predictive analytics? That's question number one. Question number two, in India, how much is the scope for analytics in machine to machine or Internet of Things beyond Google and Facebook?
See, I work in automobiles. I
have
worked in manufacturing and mechanical engineering. And I work for City and a couple of outsourcing companies in financial services. Amenability as a sector, I should not comment on. I can't. It keeps changing, but amenability depends upon the organization. Sectors which generate a lot of data were traditionally finance, telecom, healthcare, retail. Manufacturing generates a lot of data, much more data than anything else. But it was either not captured or it was just ignored. Machine to machine analytics will only grow. Because it's, you know, so there is a saturation in the level of analytics you can do in selling credit cards, but there is no saturation as such in doing warranty analysis for Tata's or Mahindra's, you know. And there is no saturation as of now I see in manufacturing, in predicting fatigue, in doing proactive repairs than reactive repairs. Internet of Things is again one of those, you know, there was this Gartner hype cycle. So has this hype reached a level where it is definitely going to grow? I don't know. But every 5 years or so you come across, it used to be called business analytics, now it's data science, you know, now it's Internet of Things. I don't know. Will it be a full trend? I don't know, but it has not reached saturation. You don't care about the sector, you care about how many clients you can get. I think we can get enough clients at machine to machine learning in the Indian manufacturing sector.
Probability increases, but you're
yeah,
not sure.
And probability increases, and let's not forget, we are next to China, the biggest manufacturer here, and one day we'll forget the war in 1960, whatever, and figure out that we can do business with the Chinese. That's where I see a big opportunity in terms of analytics, because we are the biggest service providers, they are the biggest manufacturing providers. Most of our antipathy is actually colonial.
Right, I think that's the time we have. You can use the questions in a panel discussion sometime later, and also during one of the tea breaks. So I wanted to keep them reserved.
I have a question precisely.
No, no price for this question though. You can still go ahead and ask. Yeah.
That's okay. So sure. I have a question. My name is Puneet. What are the important parameters for any startup has to consider for an e-commerce kind of a business? So
parameters for?
My name is Puneet. So I have a question. What are the important parameters I need to ask my customer while enrolling somebody or customer on my website? So what should I ask him? I mean, in terms of data, so that I can analyze further and accordingly I can send information to him. Because even I can't ask 10-20 questions while enrolling, because then he will leave it between. So I am not sure what are important parameters which are really, really critical.
What are you doing in e-commerce? Are you trying to sell cake? Are you trying to sell?
It is a good enough. Healthcare, for example, I take a SaaS kind of a business which is in healthcare.
So the SaaS kind of business in healthcare is something that I've talked about at least 10 times in the past 6 months. What? Do you want digital health records? Do you want testing? Do you want lifestyle management? So you see, your data questions will be specific to your domain. I as a data scientist slash statistician cannot and should not help you. If you ask this and a paid gig as a consultant, I will probably give you a much better answer than this. But I should not. What I can say is, if you ask more than 3 questions on a website, you will lose people.